Hey, it's Brad Brinkman from EXP Realty, and I'm here to talk to you about mistake number 7 from my ebook called The 7 Common Mistakes Most Probate Executors and Administrators Make and How to Avoid Them in Under 10 Minutes. If you have not got a copy of my ebook already, go ahead and text me your email and I'll get that to you right away. Now, mistake number 7 is attempting to sell the real estate that's held in the probate estate without understanding the current market conditions. So there are two valuations that are key for the real estate that's held in the probate estate. Evaluation number 1 was the date of death evaluation. So that is the value of the property at the time of the decedent's death. Oftentimes that's different than what the current market value is, and you'll need to know what both of those are. You should have that done through what they call a probate broker price opinion. Now, the probate broker price opinion is done by a certified probate real estate specialist like myself. This is important to have because when you know what the current value of the property held in the probate estate is, you can go to the court with confidence once the property has been sold, knowing that you have all the documentation you need to support the value. The mistakes that I've seen is sometimes administrators and executors sell the property at whatever the value was at the date of death without knowing what the current market value is. And that's a big mistake because a lot of times heirs will dispute the sale in court or, unfortunately, sometimes even after the probate estate has settled, they will sue the administrator or the executor because they think they have undersold the property. So it is important that you have this well documented and know that you can count on me to provide you with a probate broker price opinion if you need it. And if, of course, if anything else I can help you with, because I am your resource for everything probate related. Brad Brinkman, EXP Realty. I look forward to helping you. Please give me a call or a text or an email if I can help you with anything. Thank you.